Take a look at the picture on the screen. Over here, you will find that these men are looking into some sort of an instrument or a device. Now, what do you think this device does? First of all, let me tell you that this is inside a submarine. A submarine is kind of a ship that travels inside water or under the surface of water. Now, if these men are inside the submarine, which is inside water, what are they seeing exactly? You will be surprised to know that with this instrument, they are seeing things that are above water, whether there are any threats around or not. So if they are under the sea, how are they able to see above water? This instrument is known as a periscope, and it is with the help of a periscope that these people are able to see what lies above water from underwater. So this is what a periscope looks like. For the periscope to work, first of all, the submarine has to be at a shallow depth, and the periscope sticks out of water, as you can see from this picture. So how does a periscope function? What is the working principle behind the periscope in a submarine? Let us find out. So consider this animation. In this animation, a ray of light has been considered, which is incident on the periscope. Now, as you can see from this animation, two prisms have been taken. These two prisms are placed inside the periscope in a manner as you can see. If you observe closely, you will find that the ray of light, which is incident on the first prism at the top, is undergoing reflection, falling on the second prism, where it is again undergoing reflection, and then it is reaching the observer's eyes. Now let us get to the details of what is happening over here with the help of certain ray diagrams. In this animation, we analyze what is taking place inside the first prism. Now if you observe closely, you will find that rays of light are incident on surface PQ of the prism. Now the prism that has been considered is a right-angled prism. In other words, the angle in between the two refracting surfaces PQ and QR is 90 degrees. That is, A is equal to 90 degrees. So these rays of light are considered falling normally on surface PQ. So once they are falling normally on surface PQ, let us find out what is happening. So we find that when these rays are incident normally on surface PQ, the angle of incidence is 90 degrees. Now we have studied that when there is a change in medium, when the angle of incidence is 90 degrees, the rays pass through without any refraction. So no refraction takes place at surface PQ, and these rays come and hit surface PR. Now we have been given that the angle of prism is 90 degrees and that surfaces PQ and QR are equal in length. Thus, we can say that this angle QPR is equal to angle QRP, which will be equal to 45 degrees. Why? Because we all know that inside a triangle, the sum of internal angles is equal to 180 degrees. Thus, we can say that this angle will be equal to this angle, which will be equal to 45 degrees. Now, we draw normals at the points of incidence. We will find that when we have drawn a normal at the point of incidence, we can easily calculate what the angle of incidence for these blue rays are on surface PR. This angle has been given to us as 45 degrees. And we know that the rays are incident at 90 degrees. So these angles will also be 90 degrees. Thus, if we consider this triangle, since the sum of internal angles is equal to 180 degrees, this is 90 degrees and this is 45. So obviously this angle will be 45 degrees. Now we have drawn a normal at the point of incidence. So if this is a normal, we know that this angle will be 90 degrees, and we just found out that this angle is 45 degrees. So 90 minus 45 gives us 45, and thus the angle of incidence is also 45 degrees. Now, if you recall, the angle, the critical angle, that is IC, for glass air medium was 42 degrees. And we find that the incident angle is 45 degrees. So clearly, I is greater than IC. So what can we say? Since the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, total internal reflection takes place. So once total internal reflection is taking place, these rays depicted in blue are reflected and are coming out as green rays. So the angle of incidence will be equal to the angle of reflection. So these angles will also be 45 degrees. Now we have to find out what happens at surface QR. Now consider one of these green rays. We just found out that the angle of reflection is 45 degrees and we have drawn a normal at the points of incidences. So if this angle is 45 degrees and this entire angle is 90 degrees, so what can we say about this angle? This angle will also be 45 degrees. So if we consider this triangle, that is, if we consider this triangle, if this angle is 45 degrees and this angle is 45 degrees, obviously this angle will be 90 degrees. Why? Because as I mentioned previously, the sum of internal angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. So these angles will be all 90 degrees. And since these rays are incident on the glass air interface at an angle of 90 degrees, again, they will not undergo any refraction. So we can see that a parallel beam of rays, when it is incident normally on surface PQ, is emerging from the glass prism from surface QR without any refraction. Because in this case also, they remain parallel. And as we saw, total internal reflection had taken place at surface PR. So, if we consider the same animation again, we will find that once the rays travel from the first prism to the second prism, a similar thing takes place. Just as I explained earlier, in the case of the first prism, where the rays were getting totally internally reflected, even in the case of the second prism, a similar thing happens because these rays are again incident normally at the surface, they undergo total internal reflection and they pass out of this prism without any refraction, because again, they are incident normally at this surface of the prism, as you can see from the blue ray. And in such a way, they reach the observer's eyes. So if you notice closely in this case, the ray which was originally traveling in the forward direction keeps traveling in the forward direction but is slightly shifted. So it is due to this reason that the observer is able to see what lies above the surface of the water with the help of a periscope and exactly where the object and image are supposed to be. There is no deviation because the path of the ray of light continues in the forward direction both in the first case and in the emerging ray case. Now let us find out if we keep the prisms at some different orientations, what happens? Now let us say we have kept the prism in this manner. Do you think it will fulfill the purpose of a periscope? Let us see. So let's say we have an object AB from which light rays are incident on surface PR. Now if you observe the animation closely, you will find that this object AB is not forming an image on the other side of the prism. It is forming an image on the same side. So let us find out in details through ray diagram what is happening. Over here, we consider two rays that are incident on the prism at 90 degrees. So these will pass through without any refraction and are incident on surface PQ. Now since this angle is 90 and this angle is 45, as we have previously seen, this angle is 45 degrees. And since we have drawn a normal at the point of incidence and this angle is 45, So this particular angle will also be 45 because this is a normal at the point of incidence. So the angle of incidence at the glass air interface is equal to 45 degrees, which is again greater than IC, which is equal to 42 degrees. So total internal reflection takes place. After total internal reflection, these rays depicted in green are incident on surface QR. Again at QR, a similar thing happens. The angle of incidence is 45 degrees, which is again greater than the critical angle. So again, total internal reflection takes place. And as a result, the rays are reflected at an angle of 45 degrees and they emerge in the direction in which they were coming, but it is opposite. That is, the incident rays were in this direction and the emergent ray is in this direction. And since these blue rays are incident on surface PR, normally there is no refraction taking place. So clearly, it is not fulfilling the purpose of the periscope, because we can see that there is a deviation in the path of light. The path of light, which was originally going this way, is now coming out in this way. So there is a 180 degrees deviation in the path of light. It is coming back opposite to which it had entered. Now let us consider another scenario. In this case, we have considered a glass prism whose angle is 60 degrees. That is, the angle of prism for this case is 60 degrees. And we consider the scenario where an incident ray falls on surface AB. So now let us find out if we can use this for the purpose of the periscope. So we consider a ray that is incident normally on surface AB. So since it is incident normally on the air-glass interface, no refraction occurs. This ray travels inside glass and hits surface AC. So at this point, we have drawn a normal. Now we have been given that AB is equal to AC. That is, it is an isosceles prism. And this angle is 60 degrees. So since the total internal angles in a triangle is 180 degrees, we can say that this angle and this angle, that is angle ACB and angle ABC, are also 60 degrees. Now let us see what is happening. We have said that this is the normal at the point of incidence and this angle is 60 degrees. So this angle is 60 and this angle is 90. So 90 plus 60 is 150. And in this particular triangle, this angle will be 30 degrees because the sum of internal angles is 180 degrees. So if this is 30, this angle will be 60. Because as I mentioned, this is a normal at the point of incidence. This is a normal. So the angle of incidence at surface AC is 60 degrees. So 60 degrees is clearly greater than 42 degrees, which is the critical angle for glass air media. So it undergoes total internal reflection and is reflected at an angle of 60 degrees. Now, this angle is 60 degrees, so this angle will be 30 degrees. Why? Because as I mentioned, that this is a normal, so this angle total is 90 degrees. And this angle is 60 degrees, so this will be 30 degrees. So if this is 30 degrees and angle ACB is 60 degrees, this ray that has been depicted in green will be emerging from the prism at an angle of 90 degrees, and this is why it undergoes no refraction. And now you can see that the initial path of the prism was in this direction and the ray comes out in this direction. So there has been a deviation in the path of the light ray. So clearly, this also cannot be used in the case of a periscope, because as we saw in a periscope, there was no deviation, no angle of deviation in between the incident ray and the emergent ray. Now we consider another case. In this case, a ray of light is taken incident at surface BC. Again, for this case, we have considered a different glass prism. The angle of prism is 90 degrees, this angle is 30 degrees, and this angle is 60 degrees. That is, angle BAC is 30 degrees, and angle BCA is 60 degrees. So let us see what is happening. When it is incident at an angle of 90 degrees, it is hitting the surface AC without any refraction at surface BC. At this point, a normal has been drawn, and we can see that the angle of incidence is 60 degrees. Why? Because if this is 90 and this is given as 60, so this angle will be 30, because the sum of internal angles should be 180 degrees, and we have drawn a normal at point R. So this entire angle will be 90 degrees. So if this angle is 30 degrees, this angle will be 60 degrees. So it is incident at an angle of 60 degrees on surface AC. Now obviously, 60 degrees is greater than 42 degrees. So as a result, it undergoes total internal reflection. After total internal reflection, which occurs again at an angle of 60 degrees, because angle I will be equal to angle R, this ray, depicted in green, travels and is incident on surface BA. Now we have seen that this angle is 30 degrees and this angle is 60, so this angle is 30 degrees. So if we draw a normal at this point of incidence, that is S, we will find that it is parallel to side BC. So if this angle is 30 degrees, what can we say? We can say that since this is normal, this angle is 90 degrees. Likewise, this angle will be 60 degrees. As you can see, these are alternate angles because these two lines are parallel. Thus, we can say that it is incident at an angle of 30 degrees. So what can we say? That this ray is getting incident at point S at an angle of 30 degrees. Now 30 degrees is less than 42, thus it undergoes no total internal reflection. Instead, it undergoes refraction and bends away from the normal and passes out as ray ST. Again, in this case, you will notice that there has been a change in path. The ray, which originally was meant to go in this direction, came out of the prism in this direction. So since there is a deviation taking place, this also cannot be used in the case of a periscope. We take another case and we analyze the same through ray diagrams. In this case, surface AC has been taken, and in this case, surface AB has been taken. Now two cases are considered. In the first case, PQ is incident on surface AB, and in the second case, the incident ray is falling on AC. So with these two cases and angle of prism 90 degrees, we find out what is taking place. So these two cases have been considered separately. Over here, if we consider the first case, in the first case, this angle is 90 degrees. So it passes through without any refraction. Now at surface AC, it is incident at an angle of 30 degrees. How? Because this angle is 90 and this angle is 30. So from mathematics, this is 60 degrees. And since we have drawn a normal at point R and this total angle will be 90 degrees, so we can say that this angle is 30 degrees. Now 30 degrees is obviously less than 42 degrees, and as a result, no total internal reflection is taking place. And the ray is getting refracted away from the normal and is passing out in this direction. Now this was the original path of light, but light is emerging in this direction. So there is clearly a deviation taking place. Also, there is no total internal reflection, and thus this cannot be used for a prism, for a periscope. Now we consider the second scenario. In the second scenario, a ray of light is again incident normally, but this time on surface AC. So we know that this angle is 30 degrees and this is 90 degrees. So this angle will be 60. Now since we have drawn a normal at point Q, and since this entire angle is 90 degrees, so this particular angle, the angle of incidence, will be equal to 30 degrees. Again, 30 degrees is less than 42 degrees, which is the critical angle for glass-air interface. So no total internal reflection takes place. Instead, refraction takes place and the light ray is bent away from the normal, that is, it moves away from the normal and travels in air medium. Now again, as you can see, no total internal reflection is taking place, and the light ray, which was meant to travel in this direction, is now traveling in this direction. So there is clearly a deviation. Again, this can also not be used in case of a periscope. So what did we learn? We learned that in a periscope, two prisms are used in such a way such that after total internal reflection at both the prisms, no refraction takes place, and the light ray that was originally incident on the first prism passes out of the second prism and comes to our eyes. You will remember that there was no deviation in the case of a periscope. That is, the path which the incident ray was traveling at, the emergent ray also traveled in the same way, that is, in the same direction. We also considered certain other cases for glass prisms, using different angles for the prism and also different orientations for the object. We came to the conclusion that none of those cases could be applied in case of a periscope, because in all those cases, there was deviation taking place.